Ponks. When will my Harpoon magazine arrive? 3 hours I've been sitting here by the fire, and it still hasn't come. Ah, well. Suppose I'll have to read last week's issue again.
Postie! Magazine!
They're all at last. I couldn't have waited a second longer. Jiminy Jaspers, what an issue! That good old front cover with its spiffing whaling ship braving the briny, valiant oil-skinned sailors greasing their harpoons and dreaming of blubber. Oh, I can't wait to get reading this one. Here goes.
All aboard for this week's edition of the Harpoon. A magazine for young and old across the English-speaking world, with 6 colour plates and numerous black and white illustrations. Price 7 pence halfpenny net, and available throughout the empire. All rights reserved. Our editor chats.
Hello there. Your old chum, the editor, again. And a hip, hip harpooners, wherever you are. Well, what a bumper issue we've got for you this week. I can promise you a stirring tale of kidnap, chalk, and cockney slang in our splendid new serial, Meadowfield's Maisie. Bertie the Hobby Horse is back with the next piece of your free cut-out gift. Plus, whaling for the under-fives with Captain Bonnet. And, of course, the Harpooners Club. A potpourri of puzzles, pranks, posers, and engineering hints. Now, don't forget we're giving away a brand new electric pocket light with bullseye attachment to the first reader who spots this week's mystery object, a loom, which is hidden somewhere in the issue. That's a loom. Oh, and remember, next week's edition is enclosed free with this one. So, a double feast of facts and fun. One last thing. Have you got yourself a gun yet? No? Well, guns can be pretty
The Harpoon How-To. The Reverend A. Morris, author of How to Build a Wheelbarrow, How to Build a Sledge, How to Build a Chicken Coop, How to Build a Workbench, How to Build a Lectern, How to Build a Goose Restrictor, and How to Build a Wig, this week tells us how to build something.
How to build a garden pond for profit and pleasure. Good afternoon. A well-made pond can provide years of harmless pleasure and not a little profit. And today I'm going to show you how to build one.
Plate one. A garden pond.
And there it is. For the correct dimensions, see figure one below. At this stage, we have a small but perfectly formed...
Figure one. 3 foot 6 inches by 2 foot 4 and a half. 11 pints divided by 1 3/7 of a hectare. 2 chains from top to bottom.
Circle of liquid, guaranteeing years of non-stop entertainment and pleasure. And now for the profit.
Figure two.
A small sign strategically placed nearby with pond for sale painted on it will ensure a tidy profit should a passing traveller spot it and think, goodness, how I yearn for the simple joy of a garden pond. Oh, tadpole, frog and minnow, and thou yon mollusk, back...
Page 4, Meadowfield's Maisie, an exciting new serial featuring the adventures of Maisie Drummond, working-class pupil at the Meadowfields Academy for Young English Women.
By Della Vigilante Hill, authoress of She Skated Till She Dropped.
Part the first, The Chapel Bell Mystery. Maisie, a 14-year-old from the East End of London with a passion for fretwork and mystery, has won a scholarship to the most exclusive academy in England. But by the end of her first week, she finds herself plunged into a network of intrigue. After prep, Maisie settles down in the common room to write home and tell all her news.
Dear Mater and Pater, I'm in such a 2 and 8.
This first week has simply flown by, and you won't Adam and Eve what's happened. Some of the girls are decent cos, but most are horrid because I'm a cockney. I said Mum's always entertaining MPs and judges and heaps of peelers, but they wouldn't listen. Oh, Peter, I'm sorry, I got cross with you at the railway station, only I'd set my heart on a pony.
Cheer up, Maisie. I may not have bought you a pony, but I've got you something just as good.
Peter, you two-foot rule. I can't enter the gymkhana on Ted the Milkman's old nag.
Nonsense, girl. There's nothing wrong with old crooked Milko. He may only have three legs, but his dressage will knock their brains out. Here, I'll put him in your trunk. Now, go on, hurry up now. Don't want to miss your train.
So, you be the new girl, eh, Missy?
Not half. I could have lots of larks and wheezes me old china, and I shouldn't be surprised if you ended up arrested, you're so shabby and poor.
No more than my sort deserve, Missy. Can I give you a bit of advice?
What's that?
Stay away from the village.
But why?
Well, there'll be a lot of unshaven men about, with cloth caps, enormous facial scars, and binoculars. Loading things into the backs of vans.
Struth, you're right. Look, two ugly men with distorted visages and field glasses looking well suspicious in a secluded lane.
Never mind them now, miss. Look, the towers in Meadowfields be peeping through the trees.
Bloomin' heck, my hammer beta.
Here, you'll see better through these.
Hello. Are you the new girl sobbing alone in the dorm because you're a cockney at the end of your first day at Meadowfields?
Yes, suppose I am, Squire. Who are you?
Princess Taryn of Abadab. My father's a millionaire and I keep getting kidnapped. I heard you hadn't any ballet shoes, so I whittled you a pair out of my spare lacrosse racket.
Oh, gosh, Taryn Wizzo.
Baffling but bona fide. Fascinating facts at the foot of the page.
Did you know that the stickleback has CK twice in its name?
Now you have a friend. I shall give you bags of advice, and later on we'll share some fudge in the dorm.
Taryn? Taryn! Stone the crow, she's only blooming vanished, Governor.
Good show, girls! Take a breather!
I say, Drummond! Bit of a stink about our Levantine playmate, what?
I should, Coco. Poor Taryn.
We're the 8 Mildreds, by the way.
8 Mildreds?
Yes. Well, there's 8 of us in the same form, and we're all called Mildred. Rip comes Spiff, eh? Oh, and this is our rotund chum, Bertha. She's fat with glasses and she likes jam tarts, but she's a good egg, really.
I say, poor Taryn, beastly wash...
It's not just Taryn, you know. 16 other girls have gone missing from the school in the last fortnight alone. Whoops, keep mum... It's the headmistress, Miss Snape.
Now gather round, girls. Pay attention. I have to announce that not only has Princess Taryn once again gone missing, but also the chapel bell is not working. It is strictly out of bounds. And if any girl is seen in its vicinity, either by myself or our swarthy caretaker, she will be mercilessly punished.
I say, chums, why don't we roam around the school grounds later on with a torch, looking for footprints?
Rather, count us in.
We creep past the cucumber frames and through the school gates, we'll reach the spot where I clocked those disfigured footpads. Scrimmage, the gate's locked. How are we going to get through?
Look, if you fasten all our spectacles together, they'll make a stepladder.
Good thinking, my octet of chums. Right, follow me. Engine file. Pull it off. Watch out. Right, here we are. Look, there's a shadowy figure wandering in front of the chapel in a dazed manner.
It's Taryn!
Oh!
Speak to us, Taryn, for God's sake, blab!
Binoculars!
Look! Abdul the Arab caretaker emerging in a guilty manner from the chapel and scurrying across the quad!
And carrying binoculars! And a huge crate marked Saudi Arabia with a school tie and a blonde pigtail hanging out!
What can it all mean?
So, what have we here? A gaggle of midnight snoopers!
Miss Snape!
And in a yashmak! Well, Daddy, no wonder the chapel bell wasn't working. Apparently, Taryn had been lashed to the clapper. But who by, and why had they released her? And what kind of school maintenance was Abdul carrying out with his huge crate? What of the 16 girls still missing, the strange van loadings in the village, and all the binoculars? Strange that at such a time Miss Snape should be frivolously experimenting with Middle Eastern fashion.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.